Dear students, welcome to Mathematics Online classes. In this class, we will study collinearity of two vectors in component form. Already, we know what are collinear vectors. Two vectors are collinear only when they have same line of support, irrespective of their magnitude and direction. See, suppose I take two vectors. This is vector A. And then I will get another one vector here. Let me write vector 2 into A. This is what? This will be similar to the old one. Means it will be having the same line of support. But what about their magnitude? Magnitude is different. Magnitude is different. Direction same. Collinearity of two vectors, we should not worry about magnitude and direction. Suppose I have another one here. If I multiply with minus 3 times, if I multiply the vector A, minus 3 times, negative you are multiplying, you know, so its direction changes. This is minus 3 into vector A. See here, vector A and this is 2 into vector A. These two are collinear or not? These two vectors are collinear vectors. That means what? This 2 into A cap is there, I will write this as a vector B, and this one I will write it as a vector C. Vector A and vector B are collinear vectors. Vector A and vector B are collinear vectors here. What I can write? This is vector B is equal to 2 times vector A I am writing. In the same way, you see, vector C is equal to minus 3 times vector A I am writing. That means we can say one thing here, two vectors are collinear, two vectors A and B are collinear when vector B is equal to lambda times vector A, or vector A is equal to lambda times lambda or mu times vector B. What it is? What is this B is equal to lambda A and A is equal to mu into B? That means two vectors are collinear only when one vector can be expressed as some scalar multiple of another vector. One vector can be expressed as some scalar multiple, scalar in the sense any real number, some scalar multiple of another vector. Then we say those two vectors are collinear vectors. I am explaining it once again. Vector A is there. Vector A is there, B into 2A means another one vector we got, vector B we got by multiplying 2 to the vector A. See, it will be having the same line of support. Line of support will be same. That means these two lines are, these two are parallel only. Change is happening in case of magnitude and direction. Line of support is same. That means one vector is obtained by multiplying some scalar to the old vector. That means B is equal to 2A. 2 is any real number, you know. 2 can be lambda. 2 can be lambda. In the same way, I am saying vector A and vector C are collinear vectors. Vector C is obtained by multiplying minus 3 to the first vector A. Here we write vector C and vector A are collinear vectors. Because one vector can be expressed as some scalar multiple into another one vector. In the same way, here I written vector A is equal to mu times vector B. One vector anna innondu vector ge some scalar multiple agi naavu baribodagittu andre aa eradu vector galige naavu collinear anta helthivu. This is the single concept. Okay, now what is the condition we can write? Two vectors, first condition, collinearity of two vectors, first condition. Two vectors A and B are collinear. Two vectors A and B are collinear if and only if vector B is equal to lambda times vector A. Or can we write vector A is equal to some other multiple? Yes, vector A is equal to some multiple times vector B. Like that also we can write. No problem. General way of saying this, two vectors A and B are collinear if and only if vector B is equal to lambda times vector A. Two vectors A and C are collinear if one vector can be expressed as some scalar multiple of another vector. See, we have expressed C is equal to minus 3 times vector A. C and A are also collinear. Now, suppose these two vectors, vector A and the vector B, are given in component form. Then what is the condition? Let component forms of A and B are, vector A is equal to, I have A1i plus B1j plus C1k, and vector B is equal to A2i plus B2j plus C2k. I have this. Already we know these two vectors are collinear if and only if, one vector can be expressed as some constant times the another one vector. So vector B is equal to lambda times vector A. What is vector B? Vector B is A2i plus B2j plus C2k. This is equal to lambda times vector A, that is A1i B1j plus C1k. Now A2i plus B2j plus C2k, which is equal to lambda, will get multiplied with all three components. This is lambda A1 into I cap, lambda B1 into J cap, lambda C1 into K cap. Here equal to symbol is there. If equal to symbol is there, what does it mean? It means vector A, this left side vector is equal to right side vector. These vectors are there in the component form. What is the condition for equality of two vectors in component form? Two vectors are equal in component form only when their corresponding components are equal. Corresponding components has to be equal. Yes, this means A2 is equal to lambda times A1, and B2 is equal to lambda times B1, and also C2 is equal to lambda times C1. I can write here this as A2 by A1 is equal to lambda. This is B2 by B1 is equal to lambda. This is C2 by C1 is equal to lambda. All values are lambda, lambda, lambda. That means condition for collinearity of two vectors, vector A and vector B, is A2 by A1 is equal to B2 by B1 is equal to C2 by C1. That means ratio of corresponding components has to be same. Ratio of corresponding components of two vectors are same, then those two vectors are collinear in case of the vectors in component form. A and B are two vectors in the component form, then condition to be fulfilled to have the vectors in the component, the vectors are collinear, is A2 by A1 is equal to B2 by B1 is equal to C2 by C1. Corresponding components ratios has to be same, then the vectors are collinear. Okay, now here some examples are given. We will take examples on the concepts we have studied. Example 4 is given as example 4. Find the values of x comma y and z so that the vectors A is equal to, vector A is equal to x into I cap plus 2 into j cap plus z into k cap and वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू एंड वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू टू इंटू आई कैफ वाई इंटू जे कैफ प्लस के कैफ आर इक्वल. ओके, वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स वाई एंड जेड सो दैट द वेक्टर्स ए एंड बी आर इक्वल. इट इज गिवन वेक्टर ए इज इक्वल टू वेक्टर बी. वी नो टू वेक्टर्स आर इक्वल ओनली व्हेन देयर करस्पॉन्डिंग कंपोनेंट्स आर इक्वल. एक्स आई कैप प्लस टू जे कैप प्लस जेड इंटू के कैप इज वेक्टर ए एंड वेक्टर बी इज टू इंटू आई कैप वाई इंटू जे कैप प्लस के कैप. ओके, these two corresponding components has to be equal, you know. This means I component is x here, I component is 2, therefore value of x is 2. In the same way, j component is 2 here, j component is y, that means y is equal to 2. Then what about the z value? Z value is 1. Very simple problem. Now let us take example 5. Example 5 is given as example 5. Let vector A is equal to let vector A is equal to I cap plus 2j cap and vector B is equal to 2i plus j full stop is magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B question mark. This is first part of the problem. And second, are the vectors A and B equal? Are the vectors vector A and vector B equal? Okay, simple one it is. Let vector A is equal to something they have given, vector B is equal to also something they have given. They are asking you, is the magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B or not? Let us find the magnitude of vector A. Magnitude of vector A, what is this? Square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Here z component is not there, that will be taken as 0. So here x component is 1 square plus 2 square means square root of 1 plus 4, 5. Magnitude of vector A is root 5. In the same way, what is the magnitude of vector B? This is square root of 2 square plus 1 square means square root of 5. You see, magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B is equal to root 5. Yes, we have magnitude of vector A is equal to magnitude of vector B. We have the magnitudes equal. Are the vectors, this is first part of the problem, and second part of the problem is, are the vectors A and B equal? Are they equal? To have the equality of two vectors, their magnitudes has to be same and their directions has to be same. But what about the direction here? Directions are different. That is one way. Another one way is that I told you corresponding components has to be same, you know. Corresponding components, I component is 1 here I component is 2. Yes, corresponding components are not same, hence the given vectors are not equal. Corresponding components are not equal, hence vectors A and B are not equal. Fine. This is about example 4 and 5. Now we will move on to the example 6. Example 6 is it is given as find the unit vector in the direction of the vector vector A is equal to 2i plus 3j plus k. We know the formula to find out unit vector in the direction of the given vector. What is that? We know unit vector in the direction of unit vector in the direction of vector A is a cap is equal to vector A divided by magnitude of vector A. What is magnitude of vector A? Vector A is this one. Vector A is equal to 2i plus 3j plus k, and magnitude of vector A is square root of 2 square plus 3 square plus 1 square. This is square root of 4 plus 9 plus 1. That is square root of 14. Magnitude of vector A is equal to. Now A cap is equal to vector A by magnitude of vector A. Vector A is 2i plus 3j plus 1k divided by magnitude of vector A is square root of 14. You can leave this here, or you can write one more step. This is 2 by square root of 14 into I cap plus 3 by square root of 14 into J cap plus 1 by square root of 14 into K cap. This is what A cap is equal to. Here I want to tell you one thing about the direction ratios and direction cosine. Vector A is there. That is vector A. Vector A. That is not the unit vector. Vector A is equal to 2i plus 3j plus k is there. So what is ABC here? ABC is 2, 3, 1. Direction ratios. They have not asked in the question, but simply I am telling you. Direction ratios are 2, 3, 1. Direction ratios are 2, 3, 1. What about the direction cosines? Unit vector is there. For this unit vector, how we got? We got this unit vector by dividing by magnitude. That means 2 by square root of 14, 3 by square root of 14, 1 by square root of 14 are the direction cosines of the vector. Direction cosines are 2 by square root of 14, 3 by square root of 14, 1 by square root of 14. You have to be clear enough with the concept. Now let us take the next example, that is example 7. Example 7 says find a vector in the direction of vector A is equal to i minus 2j that has magnitude 7 units. You see, find a vector, we need to find out the vector, not the unit vector. You need to find out the vector in the direction of the vector. I minus 2j that has the magnitude of 700. What is the magnitude of this vector A? Magnitude of this vector A is square root of 1 plus minus 2 square. This is square root of 5. Square root of 5 is the length of this given vector. Now what I have to find out? I have to find out a vector in the same direction, but magnitude is 7 units. So what to do here? Here what we do? First of all, we will find out the unit vector in the direction of the vector A. We will find out unit vector in the direction of vector A that will be having the magnitude of 1 unit. And then for that unit vector, we multiply 7. For the unit vector, in the sense a vector having the magnitude of 1 unit, if you multiply with 7, then resultant vector will be having the magnitude of 7 units. Simple. Now let us find unit vector in the direction of vector A is A cap is equal to vector A divided by magnitude of vector A. A cap is equal to what is vector A? Vector A is I cap minus 2j cap divided by magnitude of vector A is square root of 1 square plus minus 2 square. A cap is equal to I minus 2j divided by square root of 1 plus 4 is 5. So this is 1 by root 5 into I cap minus 2 by root 5 into j cap. This is what? This is unit vector in the direction of the vector. Unit vector means its magnitude will be 1 unit. If you want to check, you can check, its magnitude will be 1. Now a vector having magnitude 7 units is equal to a cap is 1 by square root of 5 into I minus 2 by square root of 5 into j cap. You can leave it here, or you can take this 1 by root 5 outside, or else you multiply this 7 with both the components. This become 7 by root 5 into I cap minus 7 into 2, 14, 14 by root 5 into j cap. Okay, this is the a vector having the magnitude of 7 units in the direction of the given vector. Now we will move on to the example 8. Example 8 is given as find the unit vector in the direction of the sum of the vectors. Vector A is equal to 2i plus 2j minus 5k, and vector B is equal to 2i plus j plus 3k. Okay, what is the question? Find the unit vector in the direction of sum of vectors. First of all, I have to find out the sum of vectors here. That is, sum of vectors A plus B, vector A plus vector B. The vector A plus vector B I will represent with another one vector, that is vector C. Vector C is equal to A is 2i plus 2j minus 5k plus of vector b is 2i plus j plus 3k. Now adding the corresponding components, 2i plus 2i, that become 4i. Next here 2j plus 1j, that is 3j, minus 5k plus 3k, it is minus 2k. What is this? This is vector obtained by adding the two given vectors. What we have to find out? We have to find out unit vector in the direction of this. Yes. Now unit vector in the direction of sum of vectors a and b, a is c cap, a plus b is nothing but vector c. C cap is equal to vector c divided by magnitude of vector c. C cap is equal to vector c is what? 4i plus 3j minus 2k. What about the magnitude of the vector c? Magnitude of vector c is square root of 4 square plus 3 square plus minus 2 square. This is 4i plus 3j minus 2k divided by square root of, how much is this? Let me write, 16, 9, 4. This is 20 plus 9, 29. 4i plus 3j minus 2k divided by square root of 29. Let me write one more step. C cap is equal to 4 by square root of 29 into I cap plus 3 by square root of 29 into j cap minus 2 by square root of 29 into k cap. This is what? This is unit vector in the direction of sum of the given vectors. And in the same question, if they ask you to ask the question like, what are the direction ratios of sum of two vectors? If they give, what are the direction ratios of sum of two vectors A and B? What is that direction ratios? We will get in one vector by adding these two, you know, that is 4i plus 3j minus 2k. So direction ratios of sum of two vectors is 4, 3, minus 2. Next, they ask you, what are the direction cosines of the vector obtained by adding the given two vectors? What are the direction cosines? 4 by square root of 29, 3 by square root of 29, minus 2 by square root of 29. Okay, thank you.